feels good to know what you know, doesn't it? Can't you feel the resonance of all of that? Can't you feel the fullness of who you are? Don't you love letting them all off the hook? Don't you like letting yourself off the hook?
Thank you. I feel exceptionally privileged to be sitting here.
It's a good conversation about to happen.
Many years ago, I had a dream that I would win the lottery.
You just did.
I feel that, and I would definitely like to do so immediately today. The jackpot is $93 million today, and I would like to have that happen today.
The thing about that is you can't get there from there. You can't want something that you don't have and be a vibrational match to it. You have to be what you want, and then you can have it. In other words, you have to feel prosperity equivalent to your request. So, first of all, jackpot. What an interesting word. It implies big, 93 million is. It implies rare. It implies unlikely. Doesn't usually feel like the next logical step. The bigness of it gives you away. In other words, if you said, "Universe, I could sure use more money," there's very little discord in that vibration. And if you offered that sentiment often and until you came to expect it, so that your words naturally morphed to, "Universe, I certainly could use more money. I certainly expect more money to flow to me." In that soft, non-resistant expectation, more money would begin flowing to you. But when you say, "Universe, I know that there's this incredibly large, understood by almost no one, pile of money sitting over there, and I would like it to come into my pile," the vibrational discord is so huge that you can tell by the way you feel when you talk about it, that while you might occasionally come into the arena of hopefulness, that mostly you don't expect that even as you offer the words. And we've never known anyone who could hype their words up enough to make that vibrational jump. "Universe, you could make it up to me. You could give me this jackpot and you could make it all right." And we say, "It doesn't work that way. You've got to be chronically over here in the vibration of well-being." And when you are, the universe will say, "Well, here's a way, well, here's a way, well, here's a way, well, here's a way." When you're in the vortex, this idea, this idea, this idea, this idea. And it is not inconceivable. In fact, it is completely conceivable that when you hang around in the vortex and you're feeling tuned in, tapped in, turned on, you could be inspired to stop at the 7-Eleven and inspired to of the timing of the ticket and inspired to buying the ticket that is the winning of the lottery. But you got to be in the vortex to do that, and you don't do that just all of a sudden. You got to get in the vortex. The vortex has to be familiar to you. And the thing that's so interesting about that is you tune yourself to the frequency of the vortex, and you're not saying, "I want to win the jackpot." You're saying, "Money's flowing to me in abundance. It comes in as fast as it can go out. I have no need for money. Money is flowing in. It's like air. I breathe it in, and I breathe it out, and I breathe it in, and I breathe it out, and I breathe it in, and I breathe it out. In and out, in and out, in and out. It just comes to me naturally," you see. You got to get into the vortex, and then the vortex gives you everything that you need to figure it out as you go. So, do you believe in the validity of this vortex?
Absolutely.
Do you believe that you were and are source energy, even though you are in this physical body?
I do.
Do you believe that as you have been living this life, that you have made a very powerful claim to a veritable fortune?
I do.
And do you believe that it's queued up for you, that it's there with your name on it, that it's already assigned to your bank account, that it's there for you and no one can get it away from you?
I do.
Do you believe that there's no risk at all in this money that has been amassed for you? Do you believe that it is there risk-free?
I do.
And do you understand what the requirement is for you to make claim on your fortune?
No.
Well, you're nearly there, because everything that you said yes to means you're making claim to it. In other words, you know that you put it there, and you know that it's there for you, and you know that the source within you is tending it, and you know that it's a vibrational universe, and you know that you are a vibrational being, and you know that you can find the vibration of it, and you know that law of attraction never gets squirrely. You know that law of attraction will give you exactly what you're asking for, and you know that it's queued up for you, and you know that you've got to be a cooperative component to that. In other words, all you got to do is get in the vortex. That's the requirement. You've got to get in there, know that you're in there, and frequent that place often. You've got to practice the feeling of prosperity, even though the dollars that are in your current bank account may not reflect the $94 million that's on its way to you. You have to take the emotional journey there even before you've taken the financial journey. And that's the thing that most people have a very difficult time doing, because most people let their vibration be completely in response to the life that they are observing. And that's the part that you have to work on.
Exactly.
That's the part that's tricky. So you just begin changing your dialogue. You make friends with where you are. You make friends with the life that you've lived that gave you the wherewithal to want that kind of money. In other words, you've lived a lot of life. You've lived a lot of contrast. You've been asking and asking and asking. And we're not kidding you, and you're not kidding us either, when you say that you are wanting to lay claim to this fortune that you've put there. We're all in complete agreement about that. The only thing that we're not in agreement with yet is that we know that it's yours, and we know you can find access to it, and you don't know that yet because you haven't practiced it enough to know it, because you're still, human being that you are, you're letting the evidence that manifests be the criteria that makes you believe. We're letting what's in your vortex be the criteria that makes us believe, you see.
Oh, I believe it. I know that there's a gap, and somewhere in between that gap is the practice.
This is good dialogue. I believe that it's there. I believe that there's a gap in my expectation. I believe that there's a gap in my expectation. I believe that I can close the gap in my expectation. I believe that my emotions are my key to closing the gap in my expectation. I believe that hopeful is in the vicinity of the vortex. I believe that believing is inside the vortex. I believe that knowing is in the vortex in a chronic, consistent enough way. I believe that I have access to these dollars. I believe that these dollars are there for me. I believe that there's a path to them that will be an easy path for me. I believe that the path is through the vortex. I believe the path is through my emotions. I believe the path is through the alignment with source energy that is really the larger part of me. I believe that my emotions tell me truly. I believe that when I'm frustrated, I'm not there. I believe that when I'm hopeful, I'm closer. I believe that when I'm happy, I'm there. I believe that when I appreciate, I'm there. I believe that when I make peace with what is, I'm there. I believe that when I appreciate the process of my life that caused me to put this solution there, that I'm there. I love every struggle that I've lived because that's been the fodder that put this there. I believe that the well-being that I've lived and the well-being that hasn't felt so much like well-being has put it there for me. I know that I'm the creator of my own reality. I know that these things are true. I know that I get to live the manifestational version of all of that. I believe that I can live the manifestational version of that. I think there's evidence all over this planet of people who stood right where I'm standing in terms of finances, who had a vortex just like I do that was all queued up for them, and they just found the way in. And I don't have to find the identical way in. I don't have to run around and look for people and say, how'd you get your money? How'd you get your money? How'd you get your money? Because it's different for every one of us. But one thing is a common denominator about anyone who has succeeded in anything that they have been reaching for. They found a way to be a vibrational match to what they were asking for. And that's all I've got to do. That's the piece I'm looking for.